When I was talking about relatives, I missed some relations out in the band. Oh. I got my hand slapped in the interval. Katie, can you have it to someone in the band? She looked at me there like, I'm not. Is related to Sue on percussion. What's her relation? She's a
great
auntie. Great auntie. There you go. So another relation, which I totally forgot about. Sorry. Right, so yeah, we are a family band. There you go, mention that again. The next piece we're going to play is another piece arranged by Steve Robson, which I'm sure some of you will have heard this piece before. It's a piece called Love Unknown, which is a beautiful, beautiful melody. We're going to play that, but before we do, the band have known Steve a while and he's done some other bits with the band. Some of our training band have done some things that Steve's kind of done, and also recently Steve composed a piece for the band. There was a member of the band, and if we might get emotional when we talk about this, but that's fine. There's a member of a band called Dennis, and Dennis played third cornet forever. And unfortunately, Dennis passed away in 2020, and it was kind of like he kind of helped move the band to Trimdon when the band moved. When I said earlier, moved from Thornley to Trimdon. Dennis was kind of behind that move in the band, and he played in the band all those years. He always sat in third corners, and he always kind of helped the youngsters as they came from the training band into the senior band. He kind of helped them, you know, improve and eventually move on the front row and things like that. And we lost Dennis in 2020, and one of the things we got was a piece composed for the band called Dennis, and Steve did that for us. So although we're not playing that tonight, we're playing this piece that Steve's arranged, Love Unknown, so we're going to actually dedicate this tonight to Dennis. So this is Love Unknown.
Thank you.
I did want to say it before we played it in case they put her off. But actually, when talking about Dennis, and before I mentioned Lindsay and Lisa, her sisters, Dennis was Lindsay and Lisa's dad, so didn't she play it really well? I'm going to feature another dad, not of anyone in the band, he's just. I mean, I was with. Actually, while Jeff's getting himself prepared, Jeff and his brother Paul were playing in a concert last night at Ripon, and we went to watch it, and I sat with, I was sat with Jeff's wife. It wasn't just me and Jeff's wife. Katie was with us, and I was mistaken for Jeff and Susie's youngest son, which very much upset Mrs. Hutchinson, didn't it? She wasn't happy that someone thought I could be her youngest son. So this is Jeff. He's a big chap. and he's going to play a lovely piece of music now. It's by a band called ABBA, and it's from the musical Mamma Mia, and it is called Slipping Through My Fingers. Jeff.
Thank you.
some earlier on when I said I sometimes pick pieces that the band don't like and the band sometimes request pieces that I don't like, but we play them all because we want to make everyone happy. This is one of those pieces. I love it. Some of the people, Phil loves it. Some people don't love it, but it is a brass band classic. And if you cast your mind back, I'm not assuming anyone's age, but if we cast our minds back to the 1990s, if you were in a brass band and you weren't playing this piece of music, were you even in a brass band? Because every brass band played this piece of music. When I was a kid, I remember playing this. I was young in the 1990s. I remember playing this. So this is a fantastic piece, which I'm sure most of us will know. Hopefully. And if you don't, you'll know it after this. It's called Crazy Music in the Air.
Thank you.
Alan enjoyed that one on the drums. I was going to call him Animal. The next one actually is another one that's kind of a band suggested one. And this one actually came from Stan at the back. Give him what's weird, Stan. There you go, there's Stan. You can just see his bald head. And Stan brought a few pieces to band ages ago now and was like, come play these. And this is one of the ones that Stan brought along. It's a piece called Albion Treasures. It's another Gavin Somerset one. And again, it's a lovely piece. It features a few different melodies in there, again, which I'm sure you'll recognise. It starts with Highland Cathedral, it goes Swing Low Sweet Chariot, and a couple of others, because I'm not very organised, I forgot them, but you'll pick them up yourselves. So this is Albion Treasures. I've realised, and I did say this to Katie after I wrote the programme, I feel I've just put pieces in that have loads of flugel stuff, and she's probably going to kill me because she'll be knackered by the time we finish. And I didn't do it intentionally, it's just what happened. So Katie's got the tuning part of this one as well. But she'll be fine. This is Albion Treasures.
Thank you.
What I forgot to do is decide on an encore. So we've got two pieces left. So what we're going to do is we're going to pretend this is the last piece. And then our actual last piece will be the encore, so the priest on the program. Anyway, this is where I feel like I've been slightly harsh, because we've got four soloists tonight, and I've saved the fourth solo for the last piece. I know I'm a horrible person. Yeah. And as you can see, because he's setting up, it's Phil playing trombone. So Phil's going to play a trombone, so I'll speak for a minute, Phil, to give you time to get yourself mentally prepared. Actually, Steve comes into the fray again on this one. Steve might remember this. So there's a bit in this solo which has meant to have an improvisation, and Phil wasn't sure what to improvise, so he watched some videos of other players playing the same piece, and he came across one particular recording, and he was like, "Ooh, I like what that trombone player's done with this solo." So he messaged Steve and said, "Steve, listen to this, and can you write this solo out? Write this." Improvised solo out, and I'll just play the same improvised solo every time I do it. So that's exactly what happened, isn't it, Phil? So when we get to the improvised solo, it's well, very well done, Phil. None of us know what's going to happen at that point, do we? It could do anything, yeah. It could do absolutely anything. But yes, out of all of the solos tonight, I feel like because I've made him wait till the very end and he's had a big blow through the programme, I feel like out of all solos, Phil deserves, before he even plays, I should have said the name, Wind Beneath My Wings, deserves a huge round of applause for waiting till the very end of the night. So this is our last piece.
Oh, yeah.
Phil. Actually, when we talk about the training band, Phil actually also runs our training band. So another round of applause for the fact that he runs our training band. And a third round of applause because he's best mates with Jeff, and that must be hard work for him. So he is going to play now. Are you ready, Phil? Always ready.
Thank you.
It's been an absolute pleasure to be here. We are going to finish with a fantastic piece of music called Bohemian Rhapsody. I apologise that when we finish, we're going to be rushing straight off because we've got a long bus journey home. But it has been an absolute pleasure, and hopefully we'll see you again soon. And bring your friends next time. So, thank you very much. It's been a joy. Bohemian Rhapsody. Thank you.